Hey, welcome back! In this episode, I will repair this BMW F25. On this car, I have an error message in the instrument cluster about the tow hitch. So I will need to diagnose the problem and after that I will need to repair it. So enough with the talking and let's dive in. I must first confirm the owner's complaint. Okay, tow hitch, do not drive with the trailer connected. First thing, I will need to scan the car. And I already can see the AHM module won't respond. No message between the AGS and AHM, between ECM and AHM. No message between the instrument cluster and AHM, no communication possible with trailer module, and the same message trailer module. Okay, now let's say we don't know where this module is situated in the car. We'll need to calculate the test plan, voltage supply trailer module, and now the trailer module won't respond. We'll go to wiring diagram, we will select the, let me make this full screen, this is the module, we have here the fuses, we'll select the module A36, and the ISTA will tell us where this module is situated and how the plugs will lock. We can see it's down here in the trunk lid. It's down there. Now I need to remove this panel from here. If you can see, this clip and this clip are different than rest of the clips because these clips are made to be open with the coin. You insert the coin in the clip and rotate. The same here, insert the coin and rotate it. This is done for the owner to be able to open this compartment here to have access to the battery. To fully remove this tray from here, we'll need a special tool to remove these four clips. One from here, one here in the back, another one, and the last one here. And now I'm able to remove this panel. And if you remember the image from ISTA, ISTA showed me the module is this one from here. I need to remove the plugs. And after that, I'm able to remove the module. First thing in diagnosis this problem, this module that is not responding, I will check for power. If you remember from ISTA, we have three wires with power for this module. For testing the power, I will use the lamp, a simple lamp. I will connect this clip to the negative side of the battery. With this one now I have power. In this plug, I need to have three wires with 12 volts on them. Let me see. We have this one, good, this one, good, and this one. And the last one, the brown wire, it's earth, it's negative. Always on BMWs, the brown wire is negative. I will connect now on the positive side of the battery and check for the ground connection, and we have ground. That means this module have power supply but still won't respond. And now I am testing the CAN network to verify that this module will have proper communication with the car. First I need to take a ground from the main power plug. Something like that. And from this small plug I have CAN high and CAN low. Like so. Now you can see the CAN communication, CAN high and CAN low. And from what I see, everything is perfect. You see it? The two CANs are in mirror, are in perfect mirror. Everything is perfect. This is the good communication. The peak voltage is somewhere around 2.5 volts, 2.6 volts. This is a very healthy CAN communication. You can see here the average voltage is 2.68 volts. That is very good. Let's go to the workbench and inspect this module. First step, I will remove the cover. I have here these plastic tabs. One. Second. This one and this one. I can see some small traces of water and here. And here. You can see it. And in this corner. Yeah, I can see it on the board also. Let me show you. You can see some water marks here, here, okay, but I have seen something here. You can see it. Let's bring closer. Now you can see it. Still don't see it. Look closer here. This component is identical with this one. This one have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pins. This one have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 because this pin is totally missing. And underneath this component the same. Ah, on this component is the same. This pin is missing from here. Let's go closer. And you can see this one. These pins are destroyed. Look, this component is in the air. Okay, this one is connected. This one is connected. This one is connected. Oh, the same, this pin is gone, no longer here. Was connected only in oxidation. And here the same, this pin is missing. Okay, not good. The processor pins seems to be in good condition. Yeah, but here is a messy thing. Unfortunately, I will not try to repair this module because I am pretty sure the connections between the boards are affected also. If you can see here, these traces from here are connected through these points with the traces from this side of the board. But this board is multi-layer. That means that this board have these traces from here, these traces from here, and inside the board there are many more traces. And the connection between these traces are made with these small and tiny holes. Through these holes. And if I have a connection bad here, I can put a wire from here to here and I will connect the traces from the front and the back, but from the inside of the board I will never be able to do the connection. And you can see here, this connection don't go anywhere. Why? Because this connection is for the front of the board and the traces from inside of the board. Yeah, magic. And in this situation with this module, I have only two options: to buy a secondhand control unit or to buy a new one. In this case, I will go with the new one. And I have here a brand new control unit that was opened by someone else. This is the code of the unit. This is the new code that will replace this one. And brand new unit in the brand new package. This is the new one, this is the old one. You can see the code is changed. This is the newer code, this is the older code. I'm curious if the code was changed because it's some difference inside, or the same hardware, only the code of the component is changed. This is the new one. There seems to be exactly the same parts. Nothing changed, but the part number is changed. Interesting. Okay. Same hardware, different part number. Now I will mount the brand new control unit in the car. First, I will clean the area. Perfect. mount everything back. The panel from here was missing. I don't know what it is. Okay. No tools left behind. No traces. No one needs to know that I have working here. And the module is finally mounted on the car. Now I need to program and code the module. To do this, I will use a wire connection between the head and the programming equipment. If you remember at the beginning of the video, when I made the diagnosis, I have used a wireless connection between the head and the diagnosis equipment. Now for programming, I will need to make a wire connection, and the same, the programming equipment will need to be permanently plugged in the wall socket, and the car will need to be put on the battery maintainer, on the power supply to maintain the voltage of the battery. All of these are made for a safe and correctly programming of the car. Oof. Okay. It's a little bit dirty, but I won't buy this car. Now I will prepare my equipment by connecting them. The Ethernet cable. After that, the OBD cable. And the power supply for the diagnosis equipment. Next step, I will connect with the car. I will identify the car. For this car, I will use ISTA Plus for programming. Now I need to rescan the car. We'll go to display fault memories. And we have encoding control unit is not encoded. Good. After that, we'll go to control unit replacement. Now we'll wait for ISTA to calculate the measure plan. We will select AHM from here. Display measure plan. Calculate measure plan. Now we'll wait. And after calculating the measure plan, I will do execute measure plan. Continue. Basic requirements. Continue.
2 hours later.
And the last step, we need to initialize the tow hitch. We'll go to body, initialize trailer tow hitch with diagnosis equipment. Continue. And finish! The fully automatically trailer tow hitch was initialized correctly. I have only the AUC sensor, internal sensor fault. And no more errors on the dashboard. Vehicle information, vehicle status, check control messages. No faults. And that's all. I hope you find this video interesting. If you learned something new, hit the like button. If you are like this kind of videos, consider subscribing if you want to see more, of course. And till next time, you know the drill. Stay awesome. Bye now.